if you maybe already know. I find most humans very abhorrent. I mean, very abhorrent to me. Being lazy, they're being arrogant, they're being so selfish. They believe that the whole world belongs to them, and that they're being the most intelligent species on this whole planet. Maybe I have a little bit too high standards. Maybe. But I have my standards. And if that makes me arrogant, I don't care. I stand for something. I stand for justice. No matter if it been popular or it been political correct, I will always be for the victims of any atrocity. I will fight for what being right. If I see evil, I don't can deny it. When I see injustice with my own eyes, I will oppose it. No matter if it be not popular to do, no matter if anybody is against it, that I do it. I do it. Because I mean justice. Because I stand for something. Because I be rather true to myself and encourage the radicals of others than be false and encourage my own abhorrence. Because I be not a puppet. Because I do not blindly what me being told, because I be afraid for punishment. How will you fight to one person that have nothing to lose? How will you fight against somebody that won't give about if he been murdered or killed? How do you fight against somebody that don't sacred his own life? Is fighting against somebody that's a suicide bomber. You don't can win. That's the mindset that you need to if you want to change this world for the better way. The world, so it be now, be controlled by capitalists, countries. Countries that have one only standard. You can call it fascism, you can call it vandalism, you can call it no matter how you want it, but it's still being the system of commodification, discrimination, and enslavement. It's the same system of slavery. Might make rights. The majority want it. Evil people been always in the majority. Around whole history, there's always a small group of people. A small group that have to convince the majority why something is right, if something is wrong. There's always a small groups of white privileged slave masters that have to stand up against the majority of all the slave masters before that the slaves even get a chance to fight for themselves. There's always a small majority group of white men that have to come up for the rights of women before all the women can have even a little vote, a little decision. And before that becomes serious in the eyes of the oppressors. So why so much humans become irritating? This is so blasphemous to me. If they're being accused of something unjust, if around whole history, the majority is not on the right side of justice, and the majority of people do just what the status quo wants them to do. They don't want to change. They want to have their cake. They don't want to give something back what in the first place not belongs to them. What give the slave masters in the first seconds of the decision, the right to take the rights of blacks away? Historically, the positions of sexism and heterosexism and racism being there by challenging the superiority of the intelligence of women and blacks and gay people. If you look to the historic of this, of forms of oppression, and the superiority or superiority of the, and increasing the superiority of the slave master, the oppressor, the tormentor. But what have in the first place give them the right to do that? And it's the same thing with animals. Yes, some animals be less smart than some humans. But statistics can also be misused. And that is also something that the white supremacists do. And by the way, the intelligence test being something maketh by humans, the oppressors, something so funny as well. My observation of that so-called intelligence of humans, I come to the conclusion that it being actually manipulation. What are that mean? Manipulation of words, manipulation of language, manipulation of concepts, theories that were profound as truths. There been actually not a lot of things that you can say they've been true what humans have found. The most of the things that humans claim been actually only concepts. Not truths. Most likely one of the only things that been absolute is global warming. I think that is a pretty decent argument. Because look to the whole world becomes warmer and warmer. Not in some places. That's the reason that you maybe can call it climate change in the extent of global warming. Because some places it become warmer and other places it become colder. But in the majority of it, in the bigger picture, anything become warmer. And the seas become more acidic.
The seas be not so acidic since 300 million years ago, since the time of the dinosaurs.
Well, in the time of the ice ages. Not the last ice ages, but the one that the dinosaurs been already with. Any second we destroy one, any day we destroy one part of rainforest with the size, with the big, I mean bigger than the size of New York City. Around something like 230,000 acres of rainforest. We cut any day for a hamburger, for an addiction of greed and murder. the most biggest Holocaust ever existed. And for the people there and they say, it is insulting to call it a Holocaust. Let me explain for you the real ends. First, most important definition of a Holocaust. Holocaust in Hebrew means the sacrifice of a male animal on the altar of God. So, ironic that it can be used to mean the sacrifice of a human or the murder of a human, but not by for the originally designed victims. So funny how victimizers always use manipulation and deceit to trick anybody in accepting the abuse. And also one, this one US philosopher, Isaac Bashevis Singer, he say actually in his words, What are now all that leaders of the world, all the philosophers, they have convinced themselves that man, the worst transgressor of all the species, is the crown of creation, and all other animals be nearly to provide him with food, with clothing and entertainment. In relation to them, all men, all humanity, be Nazis. For the animals, it is an eternal Treblinka. This man have escaped Nazi-occupied Poland. So, awaken humanity. And understand that the way we treated the other animals is indirectly the same essence of hatred that humans use to discriminate between other animals. Speciesism. This is the first form of hatred that people been taught long before heterosexism, long before sexism, long before anti-Islamism, long before any form of discrimination. Speciesism is the first form of hatred. If you, a person grow up and he's been told that that chicken is different than you, but he's different, that don't mean that you have to treat him unfairly. If the child grow up and see one pig and you told him, the pig looks different than you, but this pig deserves the same rights of living and liberty as you. If that child grow up and look to a pig and a cow and you say, this cow is different than you, but he have the same right to live as you have. If that child grow up and then see one person, human, with another color of hair or a color of skin, and he look to the other person, how can a person then go up and say, I think that he is superior, that he is more important? It all have something in common. If you go to the essence of discrimination, it always go that some group on arbitrary criteria think that are being better than others. Nazis believe that they're being better because they've been told it, and they think that people with blonde hair and pale skin and blue eyes being better, and because the Jewish population was richer in general than the other groups. And therefore, or the victim blame the Nazis, the Jews, for their mistakes of the Nazis, for the mistake of the Germans or Nazis, or how you want to call them. In my opinion, the Nazis that believed the absurdity of Adolf Hitler, that were the Nazis, and the people that be not fighting for Hitler and his white supremacist philosophy, there was Germans. If you want to know the truth about that. For somebody say that not all Nazis being evil. Yes, all Nazis being evil. But not all Germans were Nazis. Hitler purifies, actually. The same thing that he say, we don't murder cows and pigs, we slaughter them. Just like the Nazis say, we don't murder Jews in the concentration camps, we euthanize them. They're always used victim. Victimizers use always euphemisms. Always. And those people being too lame, or too stupid, or too arrogant, or whichever, to find out, want to find out the truth. And that's one of the most biggest errors or sins, or how you want to call it, of the humans. Nobody want to find out the truth. They all want to live in fantasy land where anything is perfect and holy. And that they don't have to stand up for their mistakes, and that they have to do something about it. The apathy is so a blessing. For somebody that have opened his eyes and have seen the truth. For somebody that have seen the truth with his both eyes. You cannot close anymore. You have to speak up. You have to speak out. You have to oppose it. Even this one quote of this one very wise quote of Martin Luther King. There is something so dear, something so precious, something so internally true that it's been worth dying for. And I submit that if you have not find something, Are you being willing to die? I say you. This person is not fit for life. Power will not come without one command. Another will be, and another shall be, and another have be. Those who prefer freedom and this agitation, being men, how well crops without ploughing the acres, and men how wants to have rain without thunder and lightning. Power will not come without a command. Well, nothing will be and nothing shall be. What I want to say, that there have to come a great revolution, a great awakening in the whole world. If we want to save this planet from human arrogance and human follies and human flaws and human psychosis. You don't be good because you've been human. You don't be perfect just the way you've been. But when you become vegan, you do actually something to reduce the injustice, the evil and the violence that we do on this planet. It is all hard enough for the animals to live with us. Have you on top of that also to murder them and eat them? We murder any year as whole humanity around something like 150 billion innocent animals in fish farms and in concentration camps that we so euphemistically refer as slaughterhouses. Most of these animals we artificial inseminate, which so actually been a euphemism for rape. They take a bare hand, put it in the vagina of the cows, and put bull semen in it. That's rape. Rape is forcefully insemination. So, awaken humanity. Animals be not on this planet for humans, for clothing, entertainment, or anything like that. Just like women be not on this planet for punching bags and sex toys for the boyfriends and husbands. Just like blacks be not on the planet for the service of the white man. Just like animals being also not on this planet for the service of the white man or the black man or the woman, human. They're being on this planet alone for themselves. They're being not objects. They're being not stupid toys. This kind of irrational and stupidity been absolutely outdated and totally 100% insane. Animals mean sentient, aware creatures. And if you then think animals be not sentient and aware, you've been crazy or something like that. If they're not being sentient and aware, how can they survive in the wilderness? How can they locate water to drink if they are being thirsty? How can they locate foods? How can they hide when they not want to be seen? How can there? Why there fly in a V formation? If they're not want to be attacked by predators. In Cudney, why beavers? If they're not sentient and aware, take seaweed around their hands and their tail. If they don't want to drive away with the water flow. So, the same always. We do this over and over again. Can we not go to the table and say any living being deserves their ego rights and their freedoms? To be not tormented, to not be turned in an inanimate object. Why do we have always to go to the table of justice to make something illegal so that the majority don't do it anymore? The majority of robots Fine that you have hurt my ramp. If you've been still here and not me click away because you've been too much offensive. And I hope that you respect my honesty. Because a lot of people don't do. Because their ego is so maniacal, so extremely big, that they don't seem to get the reality that humans be not so special. And that we be an endemic species. So go vegan and help to stop extreme amounts of injustice and cruelty and injustice. You can save a lot of water, you can save any day, any time that you have eat. No meat. You can save any day around something like if you live in America, one pound of meat costs to produce something like 2,500 gallons of water, around something like 80 cube of CO2, and around something like 18 pound of greens, and around something like 5.5 feet of rainforest. They've been destroyed only for a steak and hamburger, or something like apathetic like that. We can also feed the whole world. That's very easy. You only have to a sense of logic. Think about it. Around 50% of all the greens, all the lentils, and all the other vegetables we feed to livestock, instead that we feed it directly to humans. It'd be the lowest estimate statistics. And I think that'd be not very trustable. I think myself that actually been something like 90% of all the greens and all the other stuff on the whole world be fed to livestock for more rational reasons. But still, if we feed that percent to all the people in poor countries, we can stop on this moment or the whole world hunger. Even one group agriculture and technology, I've the link in the description below, acknowledge that America can feed 10 billion humans. We have only around something like 7.5 billion humans on the planet. So do the map. You don't have to be Einstein to figure out this conclusion. So blessed to me, all the stupidity of humans. I think myself the family is the downside of society. It is one of the reasons it's all happening. That people grow up listening to the doctrines of their parents, do what their family members want them to do. not breaking that invisible umbilical cord that still exists. Not break away from their family programming. Not learn to think for themselves and think rational and compassionful. Not learn to think for themselves. I think one of the first things that humans have to learn, particularly in this age, is to learn to think for yourself. It is good to have wide open ears and listen to what anybody has to say. But when it comes to make a decision for yourself, you have to weigh anything on its own. And put out the propaganda. And learn to recognize passive-aggressive people. Because they can talk very nicely, but they're actually used the whole time in manipulation. It trick people to accept their point of view so that they don't have to change. There's a kind of manipulation technique, and so if you know, I have said. I think the kind of intelligence that humans use often, if we give that a label. Would have been actually is manipulation. I think I find out the truth. This manipulation of people, manipulation of the mind, manipulation of things. A whole system exists out manipulation. People forget often how much of our stuff come actually from nature that we use. For example, many medicines have stuff that come from nature. Many of our maples come from nature, and all the other things also come from nature. Rubber come from a rubber tree. We be not superior to our nature. We don't can make things out of nothing. And there is a limited about so-called human intelligence and human knowledge, how far it can go. And the human supremacists that say, oh, humans can still save the planet and still eat meat and that kind of shit. You being totally delusional. Because the meat industry is also the biggest cost of global warming. Around something like 51% of all the greenhouse gas emissions. This being actually smaller. I actually think that the number's been higher. Come from animal agriculture. You have to also put in consideration all the water that be used to grow the crops, because surprise, cows be not breatharians and don't live on sunlight and ether. So like some crazy humans want you to let believe, like the human Barbie doll, that model from Russia that want to look like a Barbie doll. No, cows be not breatharians. Humans also not. We don't can photosynthesize like plants. Also, you have to in consideration all the land. We can feed.
Deer requires just 1/6 of an acre of land. To feed that same person on a vegetarian diet that includes eggs and dairy requires 3 times as much land. To feed an average U.S. citizen's high consumption diet of meat, dairy, and eggs requires 18 times as much land. This is because you can produce 37,000 pounds of vegetables on 1.5 acres, but only 375 pounds of meat on that same plot of land.
You have also to take in consideration that it can and take up for something like 80 pounds of greens to create 1 pound of hamburger meat. And also a lot more. I don't put on anything that you have to understand this criteria. But you can watch Cowspiracy if you want to have all the statics. You can also do your own research, but you have also to have in consideration that victimizers always to try to let their actions seem less evil and less destructive. So the lowest estimate is be most likely false. Also, you have to consider that cars produce around something like 30% of all the greenhouse gas emissions. This is actually not so hard. Do the map, and you will find out it. And stop with making excuses. And for the first time, maybe I've been the first animal rights activist that asks you this question. What give you in the first place the right to take the life of another animal if it be not necessary? Plants, human beings remain for 100% herbivore, from the side-to-side molar, from our lower jaw, like this, to the fact that our intestinal tract is something like 7 to 12 times the length of our torso, from this point to this point. From the fact that we sweat to our pores to cool ourselves down. From the fact that we amylase in our slime to digest starch, and we don't have enzymes in our slime to digest high amount of protein. To the fact that we actually only herbivore animals can get heart attacks and strokes from eating high amounts of cholesterol-rich food. Real carnivores have actually a small intestinal tract, around something like 3 to 6 times the length of their torso. They have a very short intestinal tract, so that they quickly can put rotten animal flesh and fur and other disgusting things that they eat before that glug their arteries. That's the reason that I quote. You can quote me on this. Also, only herbivore animals can get heart attacks and strokes. We're nothing happened by any real carnivore. But this is one of the biggest causes of death in the first world. Heart attacks, strokes, cancer. You don't have to be answered to figure out the conclusion that humans are physiological herbivores, and that we been the most healthiest also eating this way. And you don't have to be Einstein to figure out the conclusion how be right and how be wrong, and how be lying to you, and how speak the truth. I've been not sponsored by anybody. Also that you know that. I have no sponsors. That means that I can be honest and I can speak the truth. And that I don't been bonded on one contract. And that I have to lie to get my money. Even a lot of companies can actually support me. Because I promote a lot of vegan products. I make for a lot of them reclame. Marketing. But I don't want to sponsor me, so I think they find me a little bit too... how have I to say this? Real? Harsh? Honest? Yeah, that's not something that you can have in business. Business is political correct. Lies, propaganda, slander. And put a knife between somebody else's big bones and frispling it a little bit. Bit up and down. To take all the blood of it and put it in a bucket. Business is a rotten game, actually. Business told me not about it. I've seen many of that been all untrustable persons. Rats. No, that's one harassment for rats. Because rats been very decent persons. A rat don't take your money from you. And a rat also don't steal from you and manipulate you in giving their stuff that they want. And rats don't take advantage of you in any way. That's only what humans do. They're always insulting other animals. And this will actually prove how much humans actually other animals hate. Because they've been so jealous of other animals. Because they've been so jealous of their purity. They've been so jealous of their honesty. Humans can actually learn a lot from other animals. They can learn a lot from other animals. About decency, about honesty, about being just moral. The assumption that animals are being without morals is outdated and totally insane. All animals can choose to be kindful or not. I've channel, I have a lot of videos where you can see even the most heartless carnivores giving compassion and decency to other animals. And why always try to justify your behavior with things some animals do? Actually, 75% of the animals on this planet being herbivores. They don't kill for survival. They don't murder other living beings. No. They live in harmony. They live in harmony with the planet and with its inhabitants. 75% of all the animals being herbivores. So why we don't act like them in that way? Most of you also don't want to do things that lions do in the wilderness. Other things than eating flesh. Most of you don't want to walk naked. Most of you don't want to have cockroaches walking in your intestines and in your ears and other insects. Most of you also don't want, I hope so, eat your own children if you don't want to and go to a judge and say, judge, lions eat their own children. Can I justify this? Lions steal each other's prey sometimes. So can I go to some supermarket and take some food out of the supermarket and take it with me? You can also say, Cross, take some other diamonds. So can I take that as one justification and go to take... can you give my that jewels? No, I have to take it. Yeah, because I find it so glimmery. No. And I mean also a lot of things that Cross do well. Have a lot of, for example, they're being very honest and real to their family members, and they don't lie, don't being selfish. The reason that lions sometimes actually they kill their own children is for so that they don't come an overpopulation. We don't come also to a judge and say, we have too much humans on this planet. Let we go to kill some human. No. I've been just joking. Sorry. But that's the same kind of insanity humans used if they want to justify the consumption of animal products. They use one thing. One thing. That cherry pick one thing to justify mass murder on other living beings. What if a cow pick a chicken or an other kind of animal ever done in their whole life to deserve internal damnation, internal torture, an eternal holocaust on their behalf? Nothing. Pigs be innocent. Pigs don't murder. Pigs don't rape. Pigs don't castrate human fetuses. Fully conscious. Like humans like to do in the pig industry. They hang the animals, the baby pigs, upside down, and they rip the testicles out. And their penises. That's what they do with pigs in the concentration camp, in the pig concentration camps that we so euphemistically refer as slaughterhouses. Het is disgusting en het is insane. Het is obscuur en het is psychopathic. Pigs be not food. No animal wants to be a victim. Actually in the wilderness, lions give even zebras and other animals that are hunted a chance to escape. Humans don't give any times an animal a chance to escape. So why use always lions do that? Lions eat meat, so why? There's always the insane mindset of the victimizer. All around whole history, that people, it's humans, Homo sapiens, homoide, think that give their rights about other groups. Humans have done for centuries with each other, with of their gender, of people with homosexual, with trans people. Why in God's name? Why in Odin's name? Why in Gaia's name? Why in etc. Why in Yggdrasil's name? Why in Samsara's name? There's always the mindset of the victimizer to justify it. Errors in moral systems of humans. Why not go to the table and say any living being deserves our equal rights and freedom? We don't need it. So we free all the animals from the concentration camps that we so euphemistically refer as slaughterhouses, fur farms, leather farms. Go watch Earthlings if you want to see that. Or go if there been a fur farm and break in and free the minks and the foxes for me. But let you not snap, eh? Because it is a noble act, and the criminals don't have to get their revenge on you. Plan it correctly and without mistake. Therefore, the least expensive methods are the most appealing. Carbon monoxide poisoning, strychnine. It is always a justification to free beings from their oppressors. Removed from his or her cage with a heavy neck pole, the animals walk past the rows of... There's always a justification for doing that. There's always a justification for freeing innocents from tormentors. The foxes have harmed the humans, no ones. So why they think that they have the right to enslave, commodify and murder them with anoelectrocution in fur farms or concentration camps, so if it actually been. And the skin carcasses seen here will later be ground up and fed to the animals still caged. Their skin, their fur, don't belong to humans. Their skin, their fur belongs to other animals. The animals were there, been born with. It is not your right. It is not your freedom. If somebody else have not. That's not somebody's right. To take somebody else's right away. To be free. To live the life the way they want. And yes. If humans once stop with commodified and torture and murder other animals, yeah, well, and there comes laws to protect cows, pigs and other animals and squirrels from murder of humans. If that once comes one day, I will be the first one that if I see a fox killing a rabbit, I call the cops. But until this day come, I will put the moral mirror on front of our faces. That would absolute surety. No mistake. In the meat dairy egg industry, being the most biggest massacres happening from around the whole world. Around something like 60 billion land animals and around something like 90 billion marine animals being brutally executed in these places of horror and terror. Many others also in fur farms and other places of horror. In this age, we don't have to eat or murder animals for surviving. It is obscene and it is obscure. There been in this time very good fake leathers that you can wear if you want to wear something that looks like leather. And there been even fake fur that pretty look like a real fur. Only if you go with your finger on the backside, you can feel it. Actually, then it feels not like skin, but like rubber. But there been ones that exactly look like that. In other ways. So don't make excuses. So stop making excuses. If you stop with making excuses, then there come a revolution. If you stop with place yourself in the position of the oppressor, stop using the victimizer's mindset. Instead that you use that mindset, you use the revolutionary mindset.